Now, in the same manner, there are adventitious roots also which undergoes modification. Just like taproot, even adventitious root can become fleshy. So if they are fleshy, they start storing food inside. So again, same thing, the roots become thick and fleshy due to the storage of the food inside. And depending upon the shape, there are various shapes of the fleshy adventitious roots possible. First shape is tuberous root. When a single root, see, you can easily see here there are some fibers. So some roots remain as fiber, but some will swell. So now you can call it as a tuberous root of adventitious type. And then there can be bundles of them, not just one, many. So if it is a single one, the example is the sweet potato. Sweet potato is modification of an adventitious root. If it is a bundle of it, asparagus, it's a salad plant which we consume as salad, especially in European countries, it is called as fasciculated root. So tuberous root, fasciculated root. Then in the same manner, it may appear like a hand, so palmate root example, aconitum, it's a medicinal plant. Nodulose root, when it develops nodes at the tip, a swollen portion at the tip, example, curcuma amada, it's a type of South Indian turmeric. Then moniliform roots, when beads develop, example, bitter gourd or mamotica, bead-like swelling develop, all these swellings are for storage of food inside. It may even develop rings. So ring develop in the case of the roots are called as annulated roots, example, psychotria. So there are various types of fleshy adventitious root development also possible. Now, roots don't just store food in modification, they can even provide support. So now, which roots provide support? There are roots which may be on the stem or the branches, or may develop from node, or may develop from internode. Such roots will not be for going into soil basically. They are to hold the plant, to provide it some support. For example, prop root and stilt root, they are given in NCERT. Prop root is also called as pillar root, and pillar root is found in the case of the Ficus bengalensis, what you call in Hindi peepal ka ped, bargat ka ped. These all trees will develop roots coming out from the horizontal branches, and they go down into soil to provide support. Their main function is to support initially, and as they grow thicker in size, slowly they start picking up the role of water and mineral absorption. So prop roots are basically for supporting the plant branches, because it grows huge. These trees grow huge in their size. Stilt roots in the same manner are found in the case of grasses. If you have seen sugarcane, if you have seen maize plants, their last internodes and nodes, their nodes of the last bottom portion will start developing roots coming out, which go deep into soil. Now they are for providing extra support. Example, Zea maize, Saccharum officinarum, sugarcane. You can take up any example, bamboo also. These plants will develop stilt roots, also called as the brace roots. In the same manner, there are some plants which grow like a climber. They climb because they are weak stem plant. Example, Ficus pumila, example, pothos or money plant. So in these plants, you will find roots develop from nodes, or develop from internode, or can develop from both. So these roots are for helping the plant to climb up. So it is for climbing up the support. This is how roots modify. There are other functions also of the root. Accordingly, various modifications are possible. For example, assimilatory roots. Now these roots, assimilation means photosynthesis here. So there are some plants in which roots grow green color and start photosynthesis. And reason, for example, a plant called as trapa or water chestnut, or what you call a singhara in Hindi. In this plant, the roots start performing photosynthesis. Reason, roots are for water, but this plant is already in water, so there is wastage of resource, so the plant starts changing its root into photosynthetic roots. Second example of modification is hostorial roots or parasite root. These roots go deep into the host, into the xylem or to the phloem or both, depending upon whether the parasite wants to absorb only water, then it will go into the xylem, or to obtain only the food, then it will go into the phloem, or can go to both. And then what will the plant do? Start absorbing the nutrients and water from there. So such roots are called as parasitic root. Example, dodder or akash bale or amar bale, yellow color creeper, which grows a lot here and there. Example, cascata. Hygroscopic plants are found in orchids. Now, if you have gone to Himachal and all, you must have seen Nainital, Uttarakhand. You would have seen there are orchids growing there. Orchids nowadays are available in the nurseries in this area also. Orchids develop a different type of root which will be always aerial. They hang free in the air, and some roots will attach to the plant's branches and all. Otherwise, maximum roots will hang down, and they have very much great attraction towards the water. They all absorb water from the or moisture from the air. That's why these plants are found in the tropical air forest where there is lots of moisture. So their role is to absorb moisture from the air. That's why they are called as hygroscopic roots or epiphytic roots. Now the next one is reproductive roots. There are plants which can be grown from roots also. Example, sweet potato, scientific name Ipomoea batatas. So these plants are able to grow from their roots because roots carry buds. So such buds are extraordinary. That's why they are called as adventitious buds. Why extraordinary? Buds should always develop either on the tip of the shoot system or the axil of the shoot system, but this one is developing in a wrong place. That's why it is called as extraordinary or adventitious bud. In the same manner, leaves may develop into root, or roots may even develop into thorns for protection. So this is how roots are modified.